this crab right here that come out of this shell would be 1/3 larger than the shell. It would never be able to go back in. Takes time it shells. Now, the question becomes, you wouldn't realize how a third grader, especially a fifth grader, the questions they would ask. Well now, when does it do it again? Then I have to say, you've got to know exactly what you're talking about. That this crab right here started the size of my little fingernail. Just think of that. By a mother crab that went in September and buried in the mud and had eggs on them. And the eggs was the baby crabs. That was the... Then when they came, all the males were outside. It comes to May, April and May. Pardon me, the temperature of the water, the crab swims out, dispels all the eggs, and the male then fertilizes on the egg. And they come out into little sperms of little crabs. Then this crab will shed from May till September 21 times. 21 times, just think of that. Each time it gets bigger until it's done its shedding. How big was the crab then? Heard that question. The crab then, at maturity, if it hadn't died or it lived at the first age, would be 9 inches from point to point. If somebody says from point to point, that means this point of the crab is that. Can you imagine that's only about 4 inches? So a crab would be 9 inches, a soft shell crab. Now, after that is shedded the last time, then it becomes a hard crab and it won't shed anymore. That's its life cycle. Each time it leaves a shell now. All of these shells here, and then all the little kids will hold a soft crab in his hand and a shell in his hand of the age of a boy. So it's sort of like a show and a tell. You're integrating, showing something, and you're telling something. Instead of having a story of telling something, not showing it. So that is the